Yeah, very good morning, students. Myself, R. Venkatesava, Senior Assistant Professor of Physics. Now I am going to discuss the next chapter, that is nothing but quantum mechanics. So today we are going to learn regarding the quantum mechanics. So before going to discuss regarding the quantum mechanics, what is the outcome of this particular unit called quantum mechanics? The outcome of this unit is nothing but we call it as course outcome. Simply we may term it as CO. Identify the principles of quantum physics or quantum mechanics or in other words we can say that quantum computing based on quantum mechanics. Regarding the course outcome of your particular unit called quantum mechanics. Nothing but identify the principles of quantum computing by means of or by the usage of quantum mechanics. So by the end of this particular unit, student or the learner can able to identify what are the principles involved in the quantum computer or on what principles the quantum computer is working, you can able to identify. This is the course outcome of this particular chapter called quantum mechanics. So before going to discuss regarding the quantum mechanics, I would like to concentrate on the origin of the quantum mechanics. What is origin of quantum mechanics? Origin of quantum mechanics is nothing but or in other words we can say that it is same as the failures of classical mechanics. So origin of quantum mechanics is same as the failures of classical mechanics. Where the classical mechanics is actually failed, what is the classical mechanics in the sense, in the year 1960 onwards, Maxwell's electromagnetic theory generally used to explain the any new discovery or any experimental invention can easily identified or explained with the help of classical electromagnetic theory. It has been successfully succeeded in all theories, but this particular classical electromagnetic theory was failed to explain the stability of the atom. This is the first failure of the classical electromagnetic theory or classical mechanics, we can say that simply. And the second one is, this particular classical mechanics is unable to explain the experimentally observed fact, that is nothing but photoelectric effect. And the one more important failure of the classical mechanics is nothing but emission spectrum of the black body radiation. That means the classical mechanics is unable to explain the emission spectrum of the black body. So these three are the failures of the classical mechanics. Nothing but in the year 1905, Sir Max Planck came into the picture. He can able to put forward an important theory popularly known as quantum theory. Hence, Max Planck is considered to be the father of quantum mechanics. So, with the help of that quantum theory, we can able to successfully explain the what we call it as these three important failures of the classical mechanics. That is, the stability of the atom can be successfully explained, and the experimental effect, that is photoelectric effect, is also successfully explained by the principles of quantum theory and the emission spectrum of the black body radiation is also experimentally proved with the help of this particular quantum theory of radiation put forward by the Max Planck. Now I am concentrating on the first important origin or failure of the classical method. There is nothing but stability of the atom. In order to explain the stability of the atom, several atomic models came into the picture. But the first and the foremost important model in order to explain the stability of the atom was nothing but Thomson-Plumpudy model. Thomson-Plumpudy atomic model. So according to Thomson atomic model, we are having Thomson considered that the atom consists of both positive and negative charges, no doubt at all, and all the negative charges are embedded like a seeds in the plum pudding, in between the positively charged. So it is popularly known as Thomson-Plumpudy pudding model, but this particular Thomson atomic model is also failed to explain the any experimentally observed facts. And the second one is Lennard's atomic model. This particular Lennard's atomic model, Lennard adopted the both the postulates of Thomson, that is atom consists of both positive and negative charges, no doubt at all, but apart from these positive and negative charges, atom must also has lot of empty space. That is a new postulate given by the Lennard. Anyhow, this particular Lennard model was also failed to explain the any experimentally observed facts. Later, Rutherford atomic model came into the picture. This particular Rutherford, he successfully explained the he also considered the postulates of both Thomson as well as Lennard. That means atom consists of both positive and negative charges, and the this particular negatively charged particles are revolved around the positive charge in the empty space given by the Lennard. So atom consists of both positive and negative charges, the entire positive charge is concentrated at the center of the atom, and the negatively charged particles are revolving around the positive charge in the empty space. So according to classical electromagnetic theory, as long as any charged particle is moving or continuously accelerating, it loses its energy. Finally, that negatively charged particle may collapse into the nucleus, that is nothing but positive charge. Hence, the stability of the atom was unable to explain by the Rutherford model. And these three models also adopted the classical theory. Hence, they failed to explain the structure of the atom or stability of the atom. Then, coming to the Bohr's atomic model. Niels Bohr adopted the postulates of Max Planck, that is quantum theory. Hence, he succeeded in order to explain the structure of the atom. But what are the postulates of the Bohr is nothing but Bohr also considered that atom is having the both positive and negative charges, no doubt at all. The entire positive charge is supposed to be considered at the center of the atom, which is popularly known as nucleus, and the negatively charged particles are revolving around the nucleus. Those negatively charged particles, he named it as electrons, and then the positive charge named them as a nucleus. As long as the electron is moving in this particular path, it doesn't gain and it never loses the energy. But when absorbs the energy, it goes to the higher level. There it starts evolving. That is nothing but it is called it as excitation. In such a manner, the Bohr's atomic model succeeded in order to explain the one electron atom. That is nothing but hydrogen atom. The stability of the atom was also successfully explained. But the Bohr's model, the major limitation of Bohr's model is, it is limited only up to one atomic model. That means one electron atom. Now, the failures of the Bohr's model were successfully overcome by the Sommerfeld atomic model. In the Sommerfeld atomic model, Sommerfeld also adopted all the postulates of Bohr's model, but Sommerfeld he added some new postulates. Those are nothing but whenever if the atom consists of more than one electron, then the structure of the atom, the structure of the orbit is not a spherical in shape. It goes to the ellipsoidal shape. This is how Sommerfeld model was successfully explained up to certain level, but this model was also failed to explain the Zeeman effect and then Stark effect, etc. Now, coming to the last but not least, vector atom model. This is the only model which can successfully explain the structure as well as the stability of all the elements which are existing in the periodic table. This model was put forward by a group of scientists. Those includes the Sommerfeld and their students. That is Uhlenbeck, Goldsmith, all are involved in this particular vector atom model. In this particular vector atom model, apart from the all the postulates of Sommerfeld, there is a space quantization is involved in this particular vector atom model. This is regarding the stability of the atom. In the next video, I would like to explain how the photoelectric effect was explained by quantum mechanics. Thank you.